President Trump is condemning the continuing assault on Syrian rebels outside Damascus. More killing today, with the death toll for the week now eclipsing 400. Correspondent Benjamin Hall is on the story from our Middle East newsroom.
Bombarded relentlessly day and night, in eastern Ghouta, the Syrian civil war is at its peak. At least 426 people, including 98 children, have been killed since Sunday after the Syrian government, backed by Iran and Russia, launched a new offensive.
What Russia and what Iran and what Syria have done recently is a humanitarian disgrace.
The 400,000 residents of Ghouta have been starved, and bombs have struck more than a dozen hospitals.
Bashar Assad is trying to end the situation in Syria by force, and this is the only language that he knows.
2 days ago, the UN Security Council called for a resolution aiming at a 30-day ceasefire to allow for evacuations of the sick and for convoys of aid to get in. But Russia has repeatedly blocked and delayed, now arguing over the wording. Ghouta lies to the east of Damascus. It's where the sarin gas attack took place in 2013. That was meant to be the red line for President Obama. Now whole families are dying again.
I have nowhere to bury my son because of all the airstrikes and rockets. Russian planes have destroyed everything.
President Assad's campaign has been celebrated in some parts of Syria, and he insists he's attacking terrorists. But as bombs flatten the whole area, few around the world believe him. France's ambassador has also pointed the finger at the UN, saying failure to act now would be the death knell of the United Nations itself. Brett?
Benjamin, thank you.